African flag, also known as the Afro-American flag, Black Liberation flag, UNIA flag, and various other names, is a tri-colored flag consisting of three equal horizontal bands of, from top down, red, black, and green. The Universal Negro Improvement Association and African Communities League formally adopted it on August 13, 1920, in Article 39 of the Declaration of the Rights of the Negro Peoples of the World during its month-long convention at Madison Square Garden in New York City. Variations of the flag can and have been used in various countries and territories in the Americas to represent the Garveyist ideologies. The flag was created in 1920 by members of UNIA in response to the Coon Song, a late 19th century craze for songs that belittle and mock African Americans and imitated of stereotyped AAVE speech that became a hit around 1900. Every race has a flag but the Coon. This song has been cited as one of the three songs that firmly established the term coon in the American vocabulary. In a 1927 report of a 1921 speech appearing in the Negro World Weekly newspaper, Marcus Garvey was quoted as saying, "Show me the race or the nation without a flag, and I will show you a race of people without any pride." Ah, in song and mimicry, they have said, "Every race has a flag but the coon." How true. Ah, but that was said of us 40 years ago. They can't say it now. Red is the color of the blood which men must shed for their redemption and liberty. Black is the color of the noble and distinguished race to which we belong. Green is the color of the luxuriant vegetation of our motherland.
In our class, we learned about the paintings of Jacob Lawrence. Lawrence was known for his autobiographical representation of African-American life in Harlem. His style, known as dynamic cubism, used realistic subject matter with flattering shapes and bright colors. Lawrence often showed important figures and moments in African-American history to highlight in his artwork. Later in life, Jacob Lawrence was an art professor at many important institutions. Throughout the United States, he has been praised as one of the best-known Black artists of the 20th century. Students combined the collage cityscapes of Bearden and Lawrence's dynamic cubism to create their own works.
Romare Bearden was a painter, collage artist, writer, and musician. He lived in New York City during the time of the Harlem Renaissance, where he met many of the greatest Black American authors, poets, artists, and musicians. Throughout his childhood in the 1960s, Bearden was one of the founding members of the Spiral, a group dedicated to African American artists. Bearden's work is reflective of his life experiences and his best-known cityscape works. Bearden illustrates daily life in his neighborhood.
Did you hear about the rose that grew from a crack in the concrete? Proving nature log is wrong. It learned to walk without having feet, funny it seems, but by keeping its dreams, it learned to breathe fresh air. Long live the rose that grew from the concrete when no one else even cared.
Face turned to the sun. Weight on my shoulders, a bullet in my gun. Oh, I got eyes in the back of my head, just in case I have to run. Can for my people, while the clouds roll back and the stars fill the night, that's when I'm gonna stand up, take my people with me. Together we are going to a brand new home, far across the river. Can you hear freedom calling, calling me to answer? Gonna keep on and feel it in my bones. strength that I got until I die. So I'm gonna stand up, take my people with me. Together we are going to a brand new home. Far across the river, can you hear freedom call?
And greatness is in me. Hello, my name is Deshae Rhodes. The students at Felix Cook Jr. have created beautiful projects for your enjoyment. We worked hard on researching our subjects and creating displays that represent the fabulous African Americans that are so great. Our projects range from Officer Edward Thomas, one of the outstanding police officers from the Houston community, to Dr. Josephine Isabel Jones, a phenomenal woman and the first African-American female pediatric cardiologist in the United States. Our projects are created from Legos, clay, drawings, and other artifacts that we use to create beautiful projects. Come along with me on this journey.
Good morning, my name is Invita Blanc.
Good morning, my name is Vanessa Batiste.
And we come from greatness. Greatness is in us. So we have a police station right here, and we made it by ourselves with help from our teacher, Miss Isabel. She had a student to make HPD, and we made the Legos, we made the door ring, and we made the stairs and the rest. Policeman standing, we have the gun, the horse, the hat, the badge, another badge, the police car, handcuffs, a hat, and the whip, and the bow stick, I think. And then we have the police car, which is some of the kids from another grade have made them. And this
is sort of policeman can ride it and try and find the bad guy.
The handcuffs is for when they be bad and they have to tell, and the police tell the criminal to get on the ground and stay on the ground, and then put them in handcuffs and then put them in the cop car and take them to obviously the jail.
And then the weapon is to fight the bad guys so that way they could arrest them and take them to the jail.
The police hat, which is that's on his head right now, is the thing with the hat to make sure that they really a police officer.
And then the badge is to show them, is to show the bad guy that they are policemen.
The donut table is for when they trying to go eat in case they get tired and really hungry.
The belt is so they could put their handcuffs and the guns and their weapons. That way they could hold it on them.
What we have here is a stop sign, and we have the light red, yellow, green.
And then this is to hold the stop light, so that way the car could come.
And this is the stop sign, and we have a stop sign here just so the cars can know when to stop. We have the bridge for the little thing to hang, and then we have the side for the bridge can stay still. Sign right here and right here so they can make sure, so the cars can make sure that they stop and stuff.
And the person who laid the stoplight is Gavin Morgan.
Thank you.
We come from greatness, and greatness is in us. I am Laura Smith.
I am Lily Smith.
I am Lily Smith.
I have this brown part and on the bottom of the building. And I built the rest of the building, like a different color.
I built like the little stand, and I built only like the yellow and shit.
I built this one, and I also built this little yellow thing. Lollipop, something.
And then the rest we just all built it together.
This is a candy store.
I'd like to spotlight Dr. Josephine Isabel Jones. She is the first female African-American board certified children's heart doctor. She currently lives in Los Angeles, California, and she is the favorite aunt of our librarian, Miss Isabel.
caminan, para aquellos que hacen la guerra, para aquellos que viven pecando, para aquellos que nos maltratan, para aquellos que nos contagian.
Thank you. There are black people in every continent all over the world. Afro-Asians, Afro-Russians, Afro-Indians. Afro-Germans have lived in Germany since World War I. Afro-Latinos have made up a majority of the population in Cuba and the Dominican Republic. In Brazil, Colombia, Panama, Venezuela, and Ecuador, they form a significant minority. In terms of absolute numbers, Brazil has the largest Afro-descendant population outside of Africa. We are all connected. Our experiences are different, but we are still linked. The beauty of the black skin comes from its diversity and its radiant nature. Black people come in a variety of different shapes, sizes, and backgrounds from all walks of this earth. Marshmallow-covered skin, porcelain tone with freckles, pretty pecan brown with a buttery shade, peanut butter truffle tone, alluring amber with a bronze toffee with copper undertones, browned caramel skin shade, glowing milk chocolate, espresso brown skin, pure cacao, dark chocolate, melanin kissed by the sun with mahogany brown. Melanin is what gives you your glow, and you should be proud of it.
I am a man. Well, at least I will be. You see, the choices I make now will help towards my destiny in making me into the great man I will become, and the knowledge of our stolen legacy reminds me of where I come from. I won't break the law, and I don't plan on being arrested. I've never known whips or chains, but it doesn't mean my life won't be tested. I am a man. Be righteous, black man. Stay strong and on track. To our wounds, to our own wounds. Do not add salt. But wait, let's go back. Did anybody raise an eyebrow when I called myself gray? Should I have called myself average or CP time late? Am I wasted on the corner or strange fruit on a tree? Who's to say? I'm not Malcolm X or the next Marcus Garvey. My ancestors were intimidated and discouraged from reading and writing. Now teachers try desperately to make learning more exciting. Make good grades, conflict resolution, no fighting. Resist the wrong path, no matter how tempting or inviting. Your word is your bond. Believe in yourself and have faith in the one above. Be a father any seed you sow, because real men show their children love. I am a man.
Nothing's difficult.
Everything's a challenge.
Through adversity to the stars.
From the last plane to the last bullet to the last minute to the last man, we fight.
We fight.
We fight.
We fight.
We fight.
We fight.
The Tuskegee Airmen were the first black military aviators in the U.S. Army Air Corps, and all 992 pilots were trained in Tuskegee from 1941 to 1946. 355 pilots were deployed overseas, and 84 lost their lives. The pilots of the 332nd began flying P-51 Mustangs to escort the heavy bombers of the 15th Air Force during raids deep into enemy territory. The best-known pilots had the tails of their plane painted red for identification purposes, earning them the nickname Red Tails. Red Tails. They flew more than 15,000 individual military missions in Europe and North Africa during World War II. Their impressive performance, bravery, and sacrifice earned them more than 150 distinguished flying crosses and helped encourage the eventual integration of the U.S. Armed Forces.
Still I Rise by Maya Angelou. You may write me down in history with your bitter twist of lies. You may throw me into the very dirt, but still, like dust, I rise. Does my sassiness upset you? Why? Are you beset with gloom? Cause I walk like I got all your wells pumping out my living room? Just like moons and like sun with a craziness of tides. Just like whole spring high, still, I rise. Do you want to see me broken? Bowed head and lower eyes? Weakens by my soul for cries? Does my hatefulness upset you? Don't you take it awful hard, cause I laugh like I got bold minds digging into my own backyard. You may shoot me with your words. You may cut me with your eyes. You may kill me with your hatefulness, but still, like air, I rise. Out of hut shame, I rise. Up from the past, the roof and the pain, I rise. I'm a black ocean, leaping and wide. Welling and swelling, I bear in the tide. Leaving behind nights of terror and fear, I rise. Into the day breaks that worsely clear, I rise. I am a dream and the hopes of slave. I rise, I rise, I rise.
Thank you.
south. I'm going back, 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 back when my roots ain't watered down. Growing, growing like a baobab tree, all life on fertile ground. My ancestor put me on game, on time, on gold chains, with my old shoon energy. Drip all on me. I'm good at a shiki friend. Hold up, don't ask, don't ask. Sacha, not chopper, yes.